bastante.
One registration is enough for both landowners as well as the company. Or whether they need to separate the main registration.
Can you repeat again?
It's a joint venture. Landowner.
See, registration is for the project.
Registration is a.
Not for the whole one. No, no, I don't want to enter in that, you know. I know we are in net pocket, right? And I spend 2 hours every day on the other side of the bench. So, question is, for the project, the registration is for the project, full stop. That's it.
So, sir, in case of sale from both landowners, whether both the money has to be as provided.
Depends on, but it will go to the project.
It will go to the project.
Yes, sir.
But the landowner collects.
It flows from the, as you said, you are telling you, it flows from the project. Reasoning is that one.
Sir, second.
Yeah, he's responsible. If he's a promoter, he's responsible. Yes.
If the partner of the JD landowner is also responsible for this?
Yes.
Money goes where?
If your money goes to you, sir?
No, no. If the project, the developer is taking the money. The developer is collecting the money.
Who is marketing?
He is marketing. Developer is marketing.
What is it?
Landowner will be responsible also for this?
See, these questions for the reasons I will explain. These questions are best answered on case by case basis. Because you may think, but it's the nature of your agreement which will determine whether you will be treated as a promoter or not. If you say that the whole 100% selling offer for sale, as if you can pay them and you only get some money, so then in that case it is you won't even be a promoter. How can you be a promoter then? You are not a promoter. You are only getting money, right?
Yeah.
From that person. So you are more in the nature of buyer or seller rather than a promoter. Okay.
And
this is
project is completed. If the buyer goes to OC and they have acknowledgement, whether those projects come under.
You want to confirm your doubt.
No,
you are not asking a question. You want to reconfirm your doubts before you give this advice. If you have read the explanatory statement which has been given to you, you will not be asking me this question. But yet you thought you can reconfirm this.
I said CSI.
I shall like to advise you. It's not very clear.
The rule says, if it is completed in all respects.
Then you have to see there four provisos are there.
Four provisos.
Yes.
In one proviso says, if it is completed and the relevant agency is given the completion certificate.
Competent agency.
Complete agency means there is the architect.
Who is competent agency?
No.
You don't want to know that? You know that? Thank you.
No.
No, because that's another question.
No, there are two more general questions.
Thank you. No, sorry, I don't mean cut. I know.
The RERA Act definition given with respect to unbounded land common area does not envisage the total area constructed by MDLA. See, carpet area excludes the external norms. But the common area doesn't include the external norms. Then whom we should transfer this? The definition of carpet area excludes the external walls. But the common walls, it includes only internal walls and it excludes the exclusive balcony. It excludes the exclusive warranty.
That is only for sale. You can always mention in your sale data. I have no problems in that. What it says is, when you have to disclose this, that this is my carpet area. That's what the insistence is.
Percentage.
You can say that one tree in that which is growing also is transferred to you. You can say, okay, that's your same thing.
No,
you write whatever you want
to write. RERA says that we have to sell only a carpet area and a common area for the register to the association. Then this area, whom we should register?
The walls.
Yeah, external walls. Exclusive balcony. Exclusive veranda. Whom we should register? Either the builder has to keep it for
everyone. No. You are not getting my point.
Here, the definition is carpet area and a common area. What is to be transferred is a carpet area to the provider.
No, no, please read the section.
Yeah, carpet area. Carpet area means the usable floor area.
No, not that. You said only carpet area can be transferred. You made a statement just now.
Yeah.
Where is that?
and common area. These are to be.
Sir, where is that written?
Section 17, it says.
Please read it out.
Yes, sir.
Where all development works have been completed as per the Act and certified by the competent agency, and the application has been spread with the competent authority for issue of completion certificates or
What was your question? Sir, I want to What was your question? I want you to assist. I want assisting you to come to a right answer yourself. But that's a better way of achieving your enlightenment.
Then that
was it. That's why I said you want to confirm what is written there because you can give an advice. It's a fact which is otherwise also known to you by a plain reading of what is written there.
Sir, what are the principal secretaries? Lawyers and CS are the beneficiary.
Sir, what was your last question, sir?
Yes, sir. Good evening, everybody.
The promoter shall execute the registered conveyance in favor of the.
Your boss is already there asking to
Sir, what you said, the Act says, may I repeat this? Everybody heard that. Only transfer the carpet area. Where does it say?
But why the carpet area has been defined?
Sir, your question, please, was what will happen to the walls?
But it has been excluded.
Please go ahead. Sir, you transfer the walls.
Yes, but. It has to be.
If you are sentient, you can buy anything.
Yeah,
then it is okay. Yeah. Yeah. Last question.
Good evening, sir.
Whatever you want to write, I have no problem.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sir, a private layout, industrial layout, purchase on lease cum sale. Sublet on lease cum sale, is it coming under RERA?
Yes.
All the development work is over, registration is over, but lease cum sale registration.
You are offering for lease cum sale or is already?
Already done.
Already done.